Hi, this is Joy, and I'm continuing on my unpopular opinion series. And my opinions are not things that I take super seriously. So I did record another video about that. Check out my Mercury in Pisces video if you'd like to understand that more. But this particular opinion is that it's a really bad idea to make relationship decisions based on astrology. Bad idea. So why is that? Well, basically, I don't believe that easy relationships are necessarily good or that challenging relationships are necessarily bad. When we're attracted to a certain person, it's because there's something that that person can teach us, or our experiences with that person can teach us. And it's not always a super pleasant experience. Sometimes we get hurt, but you know what? Sometimes that's just what it takes to confront the inaccurate beliefs that we hold and release them. You know, sometimes we need someone to throw it in our face that the way we think the world works isn't actually how it works. Not always. And challenges are opportunities for growth, and pain isn't necessarily a bad thing. It's not a pleasant thing, but the tendency to think that any kind of pain is bad, well, I'll just say that I don't believe that there's any such thing as going off course in life. You know, wherever a person goes, no matter how it looks to other people, or even how it looks to themselves, you know, some parts of us might be like, whoa, this is a bad idea, don't do it. And there we are, doing it anyway. Just because it looks like it's not good for us doesn't mean that that's actually the case. Like, life is extremely complex. Our inner worlds are extremely complex, and we can't consciously understand our own behavior, typically. Like, we might be able to understand some of it, and I'm like super duper duper into depth psychology, which is like shadow work. Some people might understand it like better in terms of calling it shadow work. So I actually have like a much, 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 much better understanding of my own like thoughts, feelings, and behavior than I ever did in the past, like night and day difference. However, I still know that like it's barely scratching the surface, because people are, like, there's a whole world inside of all of us. And we're also all connected to the collective unconscious. And basically the point is that even though something might be difficult, it doesn't mean that we shouldn't do it. So how to make relationship decisions then, and what is the point of astrology? And by the way, this doesn't just go for relationship decisions. This is like any kind of decision in life. Well, basically, I think that the best way to do it is to do what you do. you know, it's... in my case, what I like to do is tune into my inner compass and not make any decisions or take any action unless I have clarity about it. And, you know, with clarity comes peace. That doesn't mean it always feels good. Sometimes it's painful, but there's peace with it. That's how I recognize what's best for me. It's the thing that I have, like, deep, deep inner peace about. And with that, the clarity and just faith that even though, like, it may be a rocky road, it's the direction that I need to head. You know, when I just know, that's when I know that it's time to go in that direction. Even if my brain is like, whoa, this is a bad idea, and my feelings are like, hey, I don't like this. Even then, if I have clarity about it, that is what I do. Now, am I saying that you should make your decisions that way? No, do what you do. Like, I'm not here to tell you how to live. even though I'm making this video that's like telling you not to use astrology. So you know what? If you want to use astrology to make relationship decisions, you do you. I'm a very live and let live person. Anyways, I'm going to continue talking about why you shouldn't do that. So what is the purpose of astrology? Like why even look at a synastry chart if you're not going to use it to make decisions? Well, it's basically the same as anything else that I use astrology for, which is to increase awareness. It is to become conscious of patterns that I might not have seen before. And if I'm aware of like some of the dynamics in a relationship, if I can see what's happening, then it gives me more options to respond instead of unconsciously react. So basically it's a tool for mindfulness, and it can also like help to see where another person is coming from. And that's, you know, that's a pretty valuable thing. And well, it's just fun. I mean, I'm just going to be real about that. Like my main interest in astrology is like not even for its usefulness. It's just because it's so freaking interesting and fun. Okay. That is why I love astrology. So anyways, that is my current perspective. And I'm not going to say that I follow my own like advice here 100%, because if I see that someone's moon is conjunct my Pluto, I'm like, you know, there are some aspects that like based on past experiences, I get a little bit like, oh, that's scary. I don't know about all that. But you know what? Even if that is the case, if it feels right, I'm still going to go for it, because nothing else really matters to me. You know, like if I have deep clarity and peace that something is right for me and that that's the direction that I should head, that is what I do. And that's the case even when it seems like I'm about to make this huge mess or I'm taking a massive leap of faith, I still do it. And you know what? Life is really interesting, and some super crazy things have happened. I could tell stories. Super crazy things happen where there's no way I could have possibly known that it would work out the way it did, but like it's exactly what needed to happen. And like, wow, I'm so glad I did that thing that looked totally crazy. So anyways, if you're drawn to someone and it feels right, no matter what aspects are in your chart, I say go for it. But you know, you do you, do what you want. And thank you for watching my video. Comment with what you think and what your experiences are. I appreciate it.